Hey everyone, and welcome back to the Sawickipedia. In this episode, we're looking at a pair of the Beats Wireless 2 headphones. These guys are not charging, and I've been through all the reset process, and nothing seems to work. So everything points to a faulty USB port. So we're going to take a look inside and see if we can repair it. First thing we need to do is take off the cover with the USB port side. Just slowly pry it off. It's only held down by a bit of sticky tape, double-sided tape pretty much. So slowly pry it off. You don't want to go too crazy. There we go. You can see the tape there. Put that aside. And then behind that are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 screws that are going to need to come out. So you'll need a small Phillips head screwdriver. Just remove all these and place them aside somewhere safe. Do not want to lose them. Now at the bottom you'll notice there's two screws either side of the USB port. So these actually hold that little USB port in. But you should now have the cover off. Just be careful because there are small headphone wires behind there. So if you're too rough with it, you'll end up possibly breaking one of those wires, which is going to cause you even more headaches. I'm just going to remove those two little screws from around the USB port. Okie doke. All the screws are out. And you can see inside here is a little cover. Covers up all the little terminals on the back of the USB, and with any luck we should be able to just pry that off the board. It may take a little bit of encouragement. Might need a tiny screwdriver. So grab yourself a little screwdriver and just try and gently pry this board out. There we go. There's our USB port. Get focused on it. If you look closer, you can see it's lifted up on one side, so there's probably some connections broken underneath that. Yeah, it definitely looks like it's coming off the board. Try and get focus. So, there are two ways to fix this. One of the ways is to try and resolder those joints on the USB port, which it would be incredibly fiddly considering the solder joints look to be actually under the port itself. So, unless you've got a solder station or a reflow station, it's probably not going to be an option. For everyone else who's not so lucky and just has a soldering iron, you don't need to pick up a new board with a USB port attached. I'll put a link down below for this one. And the next thing we're going to need to do is obviously take the old board off, so desolder those four connections. Actually, I think there's five connections. Be sure to take a photo first so you know which one goes back where, and then solder the new one on. So this is the old one. And you can hopefully get a little bit of a better view of what's happened to it. Out with the old, in with the new. Okay, it looks like we're done. If you can excuse my poor soldering skills, don't take any tips from that. Now it's just a case of putting it back together and giving it a test. We might just test it now. Just be gentle, obviously the USB port's not screwed in yet, so you don't want to be too rough with it. We are plugged in, and you can see a little light flashing, so looks like we're charging up. So yeah, all that's left to do is carefully unplug that again. And then we'll stick it all back together. Just test it one more time. There we are, good as new. As always, if this has helped you out, be sure to hit the like button. You can subscribe. And feel free to leave me a comment down below. Once again, thanks for watching.